Astronomical year numbering is based on AD, CE year numbering, but follows normal decimal integer numbering more strictly. Thus, it has a year zero, the years before that of designated with negative numbers and the years after that of designated with positive numbers. Astronomers use the Julian calendar for years before 1582, including this year zero, and the Gregorian calendar for years after 1582 as exemplified by Jacques Cassini, Simon Newcomb and Frieder Spanach. The prefix AD and the suffixes CE, BC or BCE are dropped. The Euro 1 BC, BCE is number 0, the Euro 2 BC is numbered minus 1, and in general the year NBC, BCE is numbered minus. The numbers of AD, CE years are not changed and are written with either no sign or a positive sign, thus in general NAD, CE is simply N or plus N. For normal calculation a number 0 is often needed, here most notably when calculating the number of years in a period that spans the epoch. The end of years need only be subtracted from each other. The system is so named due to its use in astronomy. Few other disciplines outside history deal with the time before year 1, some exceptions being dendrochronology, archaeology and geology. The latter two of which use years before the present. Although the absolute numerical values of astronomical and historical years only differ by one before year one, this difference is critical when calculating astronomical events like eclipses or planetary conjunctions to determine when historical events which mention them occurred. Year zero usage. In his Rudolphine tables, Johannes Kepler used a prototype of year zero which he labeled Christi between years labeled antichristum and postchristum on the mean motion tables for the Sun, Moon, Saturn, Jupiter, Mars, Venus and Mercury. Then in 1702 the French astronomer Philippe de la Haye used a year he labeled Christum zero at the end of years labeled antichristum, and immediately before years labeled postchristum on the mean motion pages in his Tabulae Astronomicae, thus adding the designation zero to Kepler's Christi. Finally, in 1740 the French astronomer Jacques Cassini, who is traditionally credited with the invention of year zero, completed the transition in his Tables Astronomiques, simply labeling this year zero, which he placed at the end of Julian years labeled Avant Jesus Christ, and immediately before Julian years labeled Après Jesus Christ. Cassini gave the following reasons for using a year zero. The year zero is that in which one supposes that Jesus Christ was born, which several chronologists mark chapter 1 before the birth of Jesus Christ and which we marked zero, so that the sum of the years before and after Jesus Christ gives the interval which is between these years, and where numbers divisible by 4 mark the leap years as so many before or after Jesus Christ. Jacques Cassini, Frieder Spanach of NASA lists 50 phases of the Moon within year zero, showing that it is a full year, not an instant in time. Jean Mears gives the following explanation. There is a disagreement between astronomers and historians about how to count the years preceding year 1. In astronomical algorithms, the BC years are counted astronomically. Thus, the year before the year plus 1 is the year 0, and the year preceding the latter is the year minus 1. The year which historians call 585 BC is actually the year minus 584. The astronomical counting of the negative years is the only one suitable for arithmetical purpose. For example, in the historical practice of counting, the rule of divisibility by 4 revealing Julian leap years no longer exists. These years are, indeed, 1, 5, 9, 13. BC. In the astronomical sequence, however, these leap years are called 0, minus 4, minus 8, minus 12, and the rule of divisibility by 4 subsists. Jean Mears signed years without year 0, although he used the usual French terms avant JC and après JC to label years elsewhere in his book. The Byzantine historian Venant Grummel used negative years to label BC years and unsigned positive years to label AD years in a table, possibly to save space, without a year zero between them. Version 1.0 of the XML schema language, often used to describe data interchanged between computers in XML, includes built-in primitive data types date and date time, although these are defined in terms of ISO 8601, which uses the proleptic Gregorian calendar and therefore should include a year zero. The XML schema specification states that there is no year zero. Version 1.1 of the defining recommendation realigned the specification with ISO 8601 by including a year zero. Despite the problems arising from the lack of backwards compatibility,